Hi friends, welcome to my series of videos in the normalization. In this video, we are going to be learn third normal form. So before talking about the third normal form clearly, let us have a recap of second normal form. Second normal form is a normal form. There we discussed about the partial dependency. A relation contains a functional dependency. It should not contain partial dependencies in the relation. So that is very clear, which is discussed in the previous videos. So now come to this third normal form very clearly. Look at here first, a table is in the third normal form. When we can say there is a table in the third normal form, it must be satisfy these two conditions. Number one, first condition is it must be in the second normal form. So we already discussed about the second normal form. So then second condition is very particularly has no transitive functional dependency. So earlier second normal form is talking about no partial dependency. This is talking about no transitive functional dependency. So what exactly this? So this can be other way. I'm going to be explain you here. If there is a functional dependency assumes that X derives Y. So here, no non-prime attribute is dependent on another non-prime attribute. Assume that this is a non-prime attribute. This is also a non-prime attribute in a relation. So in that case, this non-prime attribute of Y, because it is a non-prime attribute, does not depend upon any other non-prime attribute. This is very simple, clear understanding of the third normal form. Let us see with a proper example of this third normal form. Now let us take one table T. It contains the attributes P, Q, R, S, for example. So in this table it contains these. There are functional dependencies. Assume that P, Q derives R and R derives S. So in this case of this in this functional dependency, PQ derives R and R derives S. So now can here PQ of attributes are key attributes. Means these are the key attributes P, Q. P, Q are the key attributes. So then obviously PQ are key attributes and R, S are non-key attributes. So obviously you know key attributes of P, Q. P, Q are key attributes and you know key attributes are the attribute which can able to identify a particular record or particular record from the a table. So that can be helps with using key attributes. These are the non-key attributes R and S. So in this case R is normally dependent on P, Q. So as for this, assume that the table is in second normal form. According to the second rule of this third normal form, no non-prime attribute is dependent on another non-prime attribute. Look at this example of first functional dependency. First functional dependency of R is here non-key attribute. Is dependent on PQ. PQ are what? Key attributes. So this functional dependency is not, it is actually satisfied this condition of this second condition. Second condition, no non-prime attribute is dependent on another non-prime attribute. But this is a non-prime attribute is dependent on prime attribute. No problem. Now let us come to this second rule, second functional dependency. R derives S. So S is an attribute is functionally dependent on R. Now, S is what type of attribute? S is a non-key attribute. S is a non-key attribute. What about R? R is also non-key attribute. R is also non-key attribute. This is non-prime attribute. This is also a non-prime attribute. So, according to this, no non-prime attribute is dependent on another non-prime attribute. But this has happened here. So, this is not in the, not satisfied the second rule. So then obviously this relation T is not in the third normal form. This is very clear-cut understanding about the third normal form. So, if this table is not in the third normal form, so then obviously we need to be decompose it into satisfy the rules of third normal form.